Happy holidays, everybody, by Screenside here today, and I'm bringing you a new Christmas-inspired build. Wanted to do another one. I've already done one called Holiday House, but that was a collaboration, and the interior I didn't do, which I love the interior that Sims with May did, but I wanted to do, you know, a complete Christmas build because I love Christmas. And also because I was feeling very inspired to build one, because as I mentioned in my last Christmas build, Christmas is my favorite holiday. It's my favorite time of the year. And I'm so sorry. I have to apologize from the start because I think I'm getting sick again. I feel like that is all I've talked about because I got kind of like a little head cold back in November, and I have already been sick this year before I started the channel, and now I'm sick again. Oh, I don't curse on this channel, but seriously, if I did, I would have some pretty choice words to throw at the year 2016, because it has not been a cakewalk in terms of me getting sick this year. And I do not tend to get this sick this often. This is very unusual. But I know it's because of, it's just been like, I work in a situation where I'm in the tight quarters quite a bit. And so like anytime anybody sneezes, then like every last one of us gets sick. And I have like my coworkers tend to like come ask me like a lot of questions and stuff, which it's really flattering that like people trust my opinion on things or like, you know, my knowledge on things. But at the same time, that does mean like people come and hover over me when they're sick a lot. And I just want to be like, get away. I can't say that. Not really, like not without being mean, but anyway. Yeah, so I woke up with kind of a scratchy throat and I'm kind of coughing a bit. So sorry for the quality of my voice being a little bit growly, rah, but I feel okay. Otherwise, it's just a little bit of a scratchy throat right now. Hopefully it doesn't go any further than that. Please. Thank you. I don't want to be sick for Christmas. And I was gonna, speaking of which, I was going to put this out on Christmas Day, but then I thought, well, no, like it would be better to have it a little bit ahead of it in case like you want to sim like the holidays for a few days or play with your sim family, you know, doing a holiday celebration for a few days. Because I did build this in Granite Falls, and the idea behind it, it's called Yule Lodge. So it's meant to be sort of like a vacation destination for the holidays for your Sims. It's not meant to be just like a house. It's you know, it's meant to be like a cabin that your family would rent, or maybe like it's a cabin that your Sim family like has had in their family for like a long time. Like maybe it's been passed down through the generations, like, oh, my family has a cabin on the lake and we go there every Christmas, blah, 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 you know, like that kind of a thing. So that's the idea behind this build. And I gotta say, like rustic type builds, they're not everybody's cup of tea, but like this is a big steamy, delicious cup of tea for me. Like, I absolutely love this aesthetic of house. I love like warm, cozy cabins and things that look lived in and old. And I like the sort of cabin in the woods kind of vibe that this has going for it. And so the outcome of this, I really enjoy this build. And so I loved building it so much, in fact, that like I built this, it wasn't last night, but it was the night before. And I, when it was dinner time, it was just one of those days where the time that I would normally eat dinner, I wasn't very hungry, so I didn't eat very much. And then I was like, I put my, leftovers aside and was like, I'll probably be hungry later. And then about maybe like 15, 20 minutes into starting to build this, I started to get hungry because it was very late at night. And I couldn't stop building it. Like I was sitting there thinking, okay, well, as soon as I finish the exterior, I'll pause it and I'll pause the recording and I'll go grab something to eat. And so I finished the exterior and then I started to move into the interior and I was like, just one room and then I'll go grab something to eat. Just another room and I'll go grab something to eat. I wound up building for like a really long time just sitting there with my stomach growling, but I just couldn't pull myself away from it because it was so much fun and so straight out of my own personal aesthetic and what I like. So, there's quite a bit of detail on the exterior. I use this little log doodads and the doodads, technical term. I don't know what they are. They just look like logs kind of like sticking out of the exterior. And chimney, a lot of chimney action. There are a ton of fireplaces in this house. And again, that, very much is meant to be like what the idea behind it is, like it would be a cozy winter lodge. So of course there would be like fireplaces in nearly every room. And so winds up being a fireplace in the living room, dining room, upstairs family room, the porch, the back porch. I think that's it. So four. Anyway, we'll see. And of course, I did the roof in white with the idea of it's gonna be like a snow-covered roof type deal. So yeah, that was the idea there. So on both the interior and the exterior, there are a lot of Christmas decorations from using the holiday celebration pack. And it got me to thinking a lot about when I was a kid, decorating the house for Christmas was a massively, I can't think of many things that I looked forward to more than decorating the house for Christmas. The whole Christmas season in general was just like the best time for me. And I like one thing was I have a cousin she's an older cousin, and when I was growing up, I absolutely worshiped the ground she walked on because I have an older sister, but my sister and I actually are 10 years apart. She's 10 years older than I am because she's my half sister. We have different dads. So my mom had remarried my dad, and when I was born, my sister was already 10 years old. And so my cousin, she was 5 years my senior. And so like my sister and I had such an age difference between us that we didn't have very much, I don't want to say, well, we definitely didn't have very much in common, but just, I don't know. The fact that she was 5 years older instead of 10 years older, like I looked up to her so much, and I totally worshiped the ground she walked on. So, and I looked forward every summer and every Christmas to getting to see her because she lived in Texas and that's where she grew up, so I only got to see her like twice a year when she would come and visit my aunt. And so like that was a huge part of Christmas that I looked forward to. And also just decorating for Christmas and everything Christmas related, I was all about it. And I feel kind of bad because now that I have my own place, I don't decorate for Christmas like we did, when I was growing up. Of course, my mom also doesn't decorate for Christmas anymore like she did when I was growing up. It was just something that she kind of did for me because it was something that I enjoyed so much. And I'm kind of sad that I don't do that anymore, but I guess maybe someday when I have kids of my own, maybe that could will be something that will come back for me. But we had so many Christmas decorations. It was like, aside from the furniture, we replaced everything in the house with a Christmas version of that thing. I mean, we had Christmas coasters, Christmas pot holders, Christmas dish towels, Christmas tablecloths, every single like item in our house apart from the furniture, the blankets, the candles, every last bit of it we replaced with a Christmas version of that thing. So it was packing away like all the normal part of the year stuff and taking out the Christmas part of the year stuff. And there were, certain decorations and things that I looked forward to in particular. Like I have a memory of this little music box that was shaped like it was like not ceramic, but I don't know, porcelain. Yeah, porcelain. Music box that was shaped like a little like a bed with a little mouse in it. And I don't know why, that was just like one of the things that I most looked forward to finding. So we had boxes and boxes and boxes of Christmas stuff. And so every year it would be like really fun to like open up those boxes and take out the things that, I remembered from last year. And I don't know. I mean, it was just such a like fun and not to sound cliche or cheesy, but it was just like a really magical time. And I love like twinkle lights and or fairy lights, as some of you might call them. So that's another thing. And even now, I really, really like twinkle lights and string lights and string lanterns, and I still really love those types of things. I wish we actually had more of that kind of stuff in The Sims. Although we've gotten quite a few items like that, but not as many as I would particularly like. Like we got that great tree with the movie hangout stuff pack that had the hanging lanterns, but I wish that we had some version of those like hanging lanterns that were a little bit more separated. I don't know. I mean, we have different hanging lights, like the kids stuff pack came with some cool lanterns and things. But I still want more there. I still love that stuff. I still want more of that. And I have this, I don't want to say it's like theory, I don't even know what to call it, but I wish that we would all get together like as humanity and decide, or like I don't know. I mean, like I said, not everybody celebrates Christmas, but winter time after Christmas is really depressing. Like once everybody takes down all their shiny, sparkly decorations and lights and things off their house, then it just turns into like kind of like a blah, sludgy, gross winter blah situation. So I wish that we would all just come together as a society and decide to leave our Christmas decorations up until springtime. I think that would make winter a lot less depressing. Like if we could all just decide to be lazier, all of us together, and just leave our Christmas decorations up, or at least just leave those twinkly lights up until springtime, then I think we'd be a lot happier in the winter, all together. So, just something to think about. Of course, I know that that doesn't apply to everybody. Like I know if you live in like Australia, for example, that Christmas is in the summer or in the hot time hot months for you, which that would be very strange. I mean, I'm sure if you live there and grew up there, then that's quite normal for you, but that would be very odd for me. I just very much associate Christmas time with the winter time. But anyway, this room that I'm doing right now is my favorite in the whole build. It is like sort of just an upstairs family activity room, And I imagine it being like there's like a, there are a lot of toys and things in here, so it's very much for the kids, although there's a desk with a computer as well for the for both the kids and the adults. But I imagine it being like a great room where your Sims could sit with their kids and read to them in front of the fireplace. And you know, there's a dollhouse and a big teddy bear and just a toy box and all kinds of cute and fun stuff. And I really packed this whole build with tons of activity items and things for your Sims to do, because the thought would be that if you were staying in a like a cabin in the winter time, that you wouldn't be able to go outdoors much. So you would want to have lots and lots of things to do on the inside. Of course, I did put a campfire and a horseshoe thingy outside, but so you know your Sims will have things to do outside because it is in Granite Falls, and there you definitely need get together and you definitely need outdoor retreat. I used items from other packs, but those are the two that are basically essential to have this build. The rest, you know, you could get by without. I just used like little decor items here and there. Probably the, I think the next one most used pack in this, because I was looking, I tried at the end to kind of like scale back on the packs that I used, just because I know that not everybody uses them, but it does wind up having a lot of like different pack content in it. It was just that I went to look at see what packs this used, and it kept saying spooky stuff, and I had initially used a floor texture from the spooky stuff pack, but I took it out and replaced it with the floorboards from Outdoor Retreat. And I couldn't, like, I kept loading it back up and looking at it again, and it kept saying spooky stuff was used, and it was the floorboard, and I couldn't figure it out, and I couldn't figure it out. And finally, I realized, like, I put it in the upstairs dormer rooms. So I finally got all the spooky stuff, because I'd only ever just used that, like, one texture. So the downstairs floor, or the first floor, has, two bath or not two bathrooms, a one bathroom, a study room, a living room, dining room, kitchen, and just sort of like the foyer area. And every room is stuffed with knickknacks and things that to me give like a warm, homey feeling to the build, like a cozy vibe. Speaking of the word homey, I use, or I use, I watch a lot of Simmers that are not from the US. And the majority, actually, of the people that I watch are like from the UK or from Australia. And like, it's just a little thing that, and I'm sure that you've heard those Simmers as well talk about. They use the word homely instead of homey. So in the US we'll say homey, and but I definitely hear like the UK and Australian Simmers say homely, and it's just one of those things that I'm like, I every time I hear it I'm like, it causes this like sort of like little mental like glitch, like my brain just sort of like glitches for like a second, because that word to me means ugly. It means ugly in my head, because that's what it does mean if you're if you speak like, you know, American English. And so, but it technically is like, if you look for the definition of the word homely, it will actually say like in US English that means ugly. In you know, British English, it means, you know, homey, cozy, etc. It's just so funny because I hear that word used all the time, and it just is always like, there's just sort of like an always like temporary brain malfunction whenever I hear it used, in place of homey. I don't know why I even talk about that or bring that up. It's just sort of, something that I thought of there. It's always sort of like my brain goes haywire for a second. I put this little piano in the dining room, and I have a little builder's tip that I have found here recently. If you have like a wonky sort of weird corner section, which happens a lot if you, oh, my cat says hi. If you have like, if you do like an diagonal portion of the house, it seems like no matter how hard I try, whenever I do a house that has a diagonal section, somewhere along the line, there is gonna be a corner that looks a little bit wonky. And so I found that pianos are great items to sort of make a weird looking corner work out better. Because the item, like the pianos, when you just sort of set them in a straight rectangular or square room, the items themselves are just sort of a little bit oddly shaped. And so excuse me. I love like piano to me. I just kind of makes it like smooths it out. I don't know. I don't know how to say it. But if you ever have like a corner that's just weird or off, try sticking a piano in there, and I find that that's really like makes it work a lot better. The dining chairs I did alternating red and green, so there's a lot of holiday. Like, I definitely carry the holiday theme around. It's very much meant to be a place for your Sims to spend their Christmas. So, once again, I'm sorry for all the throat clearing and scratching. I actually just had to pause because I was getting ready to cough, and I did not definitely want to leave a coughing fit in the in the recording. So, which is, I'm sure you guys would have enjoyed that. And also my cat was kind of feeling like he needed to talk to me about some stuff, I guess. I don't know. But anyway, yeah, I'm sorry for all the throat clearing, and that's not like a habit of mine. If you're like new to the channel and this is the first of my videos that you're seeing, it's not like a habit I have or anything like that. I'm just having a scratchy throat, kind of a day, just one of those days. So yeah. Part of the reason that the this particular type of build, and oh, you know what, before I start on this story, I'll say that I did cut out quite a bit of the kitchen, because I did the kitchen. Oh, okay, better now, coughing again. Okay, so I did the kitchen, and then I redid it off camera because, again, like I said, I kept trying to stop building this so that I could eat. And I did, like, finally, after I had done the kitchen, at this point was when I stopped the video and was like, went to get myself a snack. And I wound up, but like, I stopped the recording to go get food, and then I looked at the kitchen and decided I didn't like it, and I redid it and forgot that I wasn't recording it. So, and besides that, this would have been like a, like, if I'd included everything, this would have been like a 45-minute video, and this is already like a pretty long video as it is with the little bits and pieces cut out. So there is a bedroom upstairs, or a couple bedrooms upstairs, that I didn't quite 100% like have in the video, but there are definitely screenshots of all that at the end. And of course, this is available for download. I'll put a link in the description below. The kitchen I did in like a diagonal section, like it's diagonal to the grid. Anytime that, like, so it makes that little sort of shadow effect over the cabinets, and it just, that comes from it being placed on it in a diagonal to the grid. It's kind of just one of those little glitchy things that there's really not anything that I can do to remedy that. So that's kind of a bummer. I've seen like some of Simmers are having glitches with their upper cabinets where they're not being lit correctly. I'm not having that problem, but I'm still having a glitch where when I'm building, curtains will look fine, but when I go, like, leave a lot and come back or reload the game, then all my curtains will be colored incorrectly. So it's sort of like the same thing that's happening with cabinetry for some people. It's happening for me with curtains. They will kind of have like this weird blue tint to them, and the only way to fix it is to like move them, place them somewhere, and then place them back. And this has been going on since for I mean since the summertime. So I've been having that glitch issue. Maybe if I what I maybe need to do is start a new build world save. Maybe that would fix that. So I'll do that before I do my next build. Maybe that'll help with that. Anyway, this is the master sort of bedroom that I'm building. So this bedroom has an ensuite bathroom, and then there's a main bathroom downstairs. And there aren't any showers anywhere because I wanted to keep, well, like a sort of an old house vibe to it. And a lot of older houses, there isn't necessarily a shower, which I know that maybe you're going like, really? That's a thing? But this is a true fact about yours truly that may like blow your mind. But okay, so until I was about maybe 6 or 7, this isn't the mind-blowing part, I'm getting there, but until I was maybe like 6 or 7, I lived in a little two-bedroom house with my, my mom and dad and sister. And then, so I had to share a room with my sister until I was about 6. And then we moved into the house that my dad actually still lives in. And the house that we lived in first, like when I was little, we had like the normal bath shower situation. But when we moved in, when my parents decided to like move into a larger house where, my sister and I could each have our own bedrooms because it's a 3-bedroom house. The house did not have a shower. So growing, like my dad has since re renovated it to have a shower in it now, but growing up, like all through middle school, high school, all that, I did not have a shower. There was only a bathtub in the house. We had one bathroom and it did not have a shower. So I took baths every day of my life. I very rarely took shower. Like if I'd stay over with a friend or whatever, I would have a shower, obviously. But, all growing up, nope, no showers. I can't imagine that now since I've been again living, away from home and have a shower, obviously. I mean, it's really weird. It wasn't like, that was a normal thing for houses around the area or anything. Like when I would have friends stay the night, they would be like, perplexed by the fact that they had to take a bath. It was just a really sort of just weird thing that was a part like barely anybody can relate to because I think I'm maybe the only person. And I don't know why my parents never had like a shower put in all those years or anything. I mean, I guess it just was just sort of one of those things where it was like, oh, well, we're fine this way, I guess. But looking back, yeah, I'm like, what in the world? That's so weird. That's a super weird thing. But yeah, I don't know. So yeah, this house does not have any showers, much like the house that I mostly grew up in. So yeah. But another thing that was an inspiration for this is I was talking about my cousin a little bit earlier. Her mom, my aunt, who is my mother's sister, she has worked in like sort of like the quote unquote like the hospitality business. So she's always sort of worked in hotels and resorts. She's like a catering manager. And so a lot of the time when I was growing up, or for several years when I was growing up, she worked at this resort lodge in well, it's like it was sort of off in like a sort of like woodsy place in the area where I grew up. And what was really incredibly cool about that was my aunt would sort of look after me quite a bit, and you know, anytime that my parents would go out of town, 'cause my dad fishes and he does like fishing tournaments and things like that. And so my parents would go out of town for fishing tournaments and things, and I would stay with my aunt and she would just bring me to work with her. So I would have free rein just to run around this awesome resort lodge place and do like there were, I mean, it had just about anything that you can imagine. Like you can go there and like sort of rent and stay in a cabin, but there's also sort of like the main lodge with like the different rooms. Like you can rent rooms or you can rent a cabin if you were to go stay there. And there's an indoor pool and an outdoor pool and a sauna and hot tub and tennis courts and an arcade and like a billiards type room, and I mean just any activity that you can pretty much think of, like there was that to do. And so that was a really awesome bonus that I got when I was growing up, that I could go hang out at the lodge with my aunt and do every kind of everything. What was kind of odd about that though is I also was just sort of running around on my own, like because there weren't my cousin didn't live with my aunt. She lived in Texas, and so I would just be sort of like running around by myself. I mean, it was safe and everything, but it just yeah, it was, I would do all that stuff, but I would usually do it by myself. But my birthday is in the winter time, and so a lot of my friends had summertime birthdays, and I was always kind of jealous that they got to have like pool parties and stuff. And I was lucky to get to like even have people show up because usually it would be too snowy to drive on my birthday. And so it was really cool that I got to have an indoor pool party when my aunt worked at that place. So that was kind of cool. She doesn't work there anymore. She's since moved on to other things, but that was really awesome. And so that's I think maybe part of the reason why I so much like this sort of aesthetic, this rustic cozy cabin. And it also had like a lot of sort of like Southwest Native American inspired prints and things throughout. It's kind of actually reminds me a lot of the Overlook Hotel from The Shining, which is my favorite horror movie of all time. So if you've ever seen The Shining, the lodge where my aunt worked kind of was a lot like that. So for like a frame of reference to what I'm talking about, of course this wasn't in like the 1970s or anything like The Shining was. So, you know, like it was more high tech, obviously, you know, but it was really cool. But it looked a lot sort of like the Overlook Hotel and the sort of there's a lot of like Southwest and Native American inspired decor and the Overlook Hotel in The Shining. Such a good movie. Love that movie. Oh man. Yeah. Super kind of weird, creepy movie, of course, because it is a horror movie. But like apart from the fact that you know, it's a horror movie so that it's creepy, it's also there's just a lot of stuff that just I mean, it's a Stanley Kubrick movie, which if you're familiar at all with his films, or it's sort of like David Lynch or somebody like those types of filmmakers, put a lot of scenes or leave a lot of scenes in their movies that are just like totally like what? What was that supposed to be? It doesn't make any sense. I'm so confused. There's like a scene in The Shining where I think it's Jack Nicholson's character, or maybe no, it's Shelley Duvall. Is that right? I think that's her name. Anyway, she is just walking by a room and like walks by, and there are like a couple of dudes in a room, and one of them's dressed like a giant teddy bear, and like I think I might know what that's meant to be, which is really not appropriate to discuss for like younger folks. But yeah, just weird, just a lot of question marks and weird things in that movie. I love it. It's one of my favorites. There are like there's an entire documentary about like what I think it's called Room 237. The whole documentary is there's a entire like movies and books and stuff like about like what The Shining is supposed to the movie is supposed to be. Of course, it's based on a Stephen King book, but there are definitely differences from the book to the film. But yeah, I really, really love that movie, and I yeah. It's just one of my super favorite, and I'm not a horror movie person. I'm actually kind of like a little bit of a scaredy cat, a little bit of a fraidy cat, you know. But The Shining is one of the few horror movies that would make it into my like top favorite movies of all time. So if you have not seen it, I strongly recommend that you do. If you have seen it and you agree with me, high five. But anyway, also. Thanks guys for all your comments and suggestions on how to fix my chapped lips issue. I was talking in maybe I'm like my last build video or something about how I've been having issues with my lips being chapped and can't seem to get it. And everybody has given me like a lot of suggestions on not everybody, but a lot of people have given me suggestions on what products I should use to unchap my lips. So thank you so much for thank you from the bottom of my heart and my lips. Thank you for your suggestions on how to fix my chapped lip situation. I think maybe it was just a precursor to the fact that I was going to get sick again. So, and I apologize for like some of the stops and starts in the audio in this video. It's because I keep sort of getting a little choked up and my throat's just itchy and scratchy. Not like the cats from The Simpsons, but like actually itchy and scratchy. Oh, I took a lot of those holiday poppers. So if you download this, you don't see it in the video, but there are like a whole bunch of holiday popper cracker things throughout the house for your Sims to go pop open for funsies. So now we're in the screenshots. Of course, this is the sort of main living room area, and you can see like all the activities and things that I put out. This is the study looking into the living room. This is the foyer full of knickknacks and things. This is the final kitchen. And I didn't really get a good shot of the dining room. I'm sorry about that. I think this is the only one that I have. This is the downstairs bathroom. And we also have the upstairs foyer. And this is my favorite room in the build. This is the sort of fun family activities room. And another shot of it with the fireplace. This is the kids' bedroom where two of the kids can sleep. There's also room maybe to stick in another bed if you decide to. This is one of the bedrooms with the chess table and a computer and a vanity table. And this is sort of like the master bedroom with the ensuite. And a nice bed. That bed, your Sims can sleep so quickly in that bed. I love that one. This is the master ensuite bathroom. And this is the porch area. So I hope that you guys enjoyed this video. I hope that you have a wonderful holiday. And everybody take care. And I'll see you next time. Bye.